I go to a G card. So.
Is that for you?
Yeah, you want
that?
One?
Oh, no, I realized when I'm
doing my knee hurts.
No, I haven't.
Oh, sorry. Okay. What? Your knee?
Yeah, my knees.
I don't know too much about
that. I don't know.
It's also something from big guys like this wet wingworm. The gi just kills me. Like I'm putting a lot of sweat in the gi, right, just half an hour into the class. But here, like, it's much lighter. I train in Egypt. The guys usually, like, a lot of them are shirtless.
Oh yeah,
yeah. It's great.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Shirtless?
Yeah. I mean, thankfully they still have shorts on.
Well, I mean, it's, even if it's really hot, like, this is just mostly for respect, you know?
Yeah.
Mostly it prevents, like,
yeah.
And rashes, actually.
Yeah, I tried to train with these, like, no, I, like, it was too much. This part was too much. Yeah, I still keep this one just for that, for kids and stuff. I have two young kids, so I don't want to give them something that they have to take antibiotics. They're already taking a lot of antibiotics from whatever they get from the daycare. So I need this part, like, when it's like that, it's just very good. I mean, if you had it, my name wouldn't have been there. Without me at all. So I was doing that. I wasn't sure what I was pushing, but I can't help but shake my hand.
It happens.
Because I felt bad after. I didn't see that. I think the pressure was sad. I didn't like that. But I felt bad for the nail because that's not part of the work.
Okay. It happens. I guess it has to be really
true. Something.
Yeah, well, when you're in turtle and people want to go for the routine,
I
have a scar because some of that is now working.
I have a scar somewhere here, but I can't find it. It was also from like a foot nail.
I get that. That's not from me, right? I don't like it. I used to kickbox. Like, I got into a lot of like mutual injuries. Like, I feel very bad if I do something. But again, I go crazy, like, you know, but like, so I'll feel very bad after.
A lot of remorse. This thought brings out all of my, like, niggling injuries. Like, bad shoulder, knees, all this kind of stuff. You're like, oh yeah, I better look after my joints.
Yeah. The only other guy that I go hard with is the brown belt. He was here last week. He's big, so he was also like 230, 240, 230 big. Brown belt? No, something? Koja?
He's on the belt. Because I think to be brown belt, you need to teach him.
Ah.
Like he doesn't want to teach him. Brown belt, Koja.
I mean, I started jiu-jitsu like 4 years ago when he was here before I traveled, and he was brown belt.
Yeah.
Like with a stripe or two back then. That's 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So he's the same thing as black belt.
Yeah.
He has to teach him.
He got me on armbar that is still hurting a week later.
Yeah.
From how tight it is, like just the second I can. But him locking it is just like enough.
Yeah, well, just his leg on it. Started in the armbar position. It's two massive legs on the training was to get the spider out of the ground or over leg. So he was but he didn't give a fuck. He was like, no, you can keep your leg. I'll just put my leg on you and try to lift it. And it's like two concrete blocks.
It's so heavy. It's so heavy.
He can't get up. It's crazy. He has a really strong legs.
Yeah. So I mean, just the pressure on. Good. Are you also white belt?
Yeah.
So technically I never spend some, like, enough time in a gym. I travel a lot.
I've been traveling to I take like a month off here.
I mean I do well against some blue belts, but if I think I do well against all the white belts, and it's the only one that is competitive to me and to her big.
Yeah.
And all my submissions are usually arm submissions, and his arms are so big, so it can still get to his arm. From the blue belt, he's the guy I suffer the most.
Yeah, he's.
Because he's like, don't let his size trick you. So he's basically a muscle. Yeah.
He's so good.
Ma position.
Ouais.
Les gros, tu vois comment j'ai dit ça? T'arrives pas à prendre mon temps.